want to fly by yourself.
Peter! Old Bob and Brooks. He's always on the move. What's Bobby's story in Neverland? I could tell him the truth if you'd only sit down and listen.
Mr. Dahlia's already chomping a fit. Now come on, into bed and lie down. Good night, my treasures. May your thoughts be tidied while you sleep, and your prettier ones be ready to put on in the morning.
Sleep? How am I supposed to sleep? Why is it so impossible? Come on, Tink, there's only one thing for it.
Can elves battle pirates?
I love pirates. They tear you limbs from limbs, and then make you walk plank.
Without any limbs? That can't be easy.
You're making this all up, Peter. You're filling our heads with make-believe. I don't think Mother will be very happy with you messing up our minds in the middle of the night.
I don't care. I want to go to Neverland with Peter and Tim.
No, Michael.
Oh, so do I. That's a brilliant idea.
No, John.
Why not, Wendy?
Why not, Wendy? You could even be our mother.
Really, Peter? I could be mother to you and all the Lost Boys?
Yes. You could sew for us, read the stories, and even took us in at night.
Oh, how I would love that, Peter. Just how Mother does to us.
Then he says we'll write this very... We will go right this very moment.
Peter, I think you're forgetting something.
Really? What?
We can't fly. None of us can fly.
Well, if I can fly, and if I can fly, then you can all fly.
But how?
Reach for the sky when you're learning to fly, or you'll never soar. You will never soar. Conquer your fear, let it all disappear. Just look straight ahead. Just look straight ahead. It's the stars we're chasing.
One.
pretty mother, pretty mother. When at last she came,
shot her.
No, Tootles, don't go.
I cannot stay. I don't deserve to stay. I'm so afraid of Peter.
I'm home.
Peter!
Quick, hide behind it. Greetings, us boys. I am back, and I've brought a long-lost mother for you all. Why do you not cheer? What is that you are hiding? Have a part with everyone.
Wendy, wake up!
Whose arrow is that?
It's mine, Peter.
Strike, Peter, strike true. I deserve nothing less.
I can't strike. Something's stopping me.
It's a shape, the Wendy lady. Look, she has the arm. I think she said, poor Tootles.
The Wendy lady lives.
It's the acorn button kiss I gave her. It saved her life.
I remember kisses. Let me see it. Ah, that's a kiss.
But why did you shoot me in the first place?
Well, it was Tink, Peter. She told us to.
Tinkerbell, come here, please. Why, you rotten fairy! You're gone from me forever!
Forever? But that's a very long time.
Well, not forever, but for the rest of the day at least. Come on, those boys. Let's carry Wendy to a clearing and make a house around her. That will make her more comfortable.
I'll take this out. I'll take this out.
I'll take this out.
Hang on a minute.
Three arms?
That's a leg.
Oh, well, whatever it is.
He must be, to take on me.
You're as tough as you come, Captain.
I am indeed.
Whilst also being a big buffoon.
Why, there's no bigger buffoon on these here seas. I, Captain James Hang on. Bad form, pirate.
I'll have you strung up like a chicken and fed to my wombat for that.
You'll have to catch me first, yep.
Pan! Pan! Come on, get him, you woman, and swap!
Grab him!
Stick him in first at the cannon!
Thank you. suit for me. Oh, the buds were so thin it was barely noticeable.
Mother was always telling Father which side was bread with butter, but I never really understood why it mattered.
So that your hands don't get greasy, John. Knowing you, you'd wipe it down in your laundered shirt. Well, not everyone's perfect as you, Wendy.
Tink! Rudeness! And what are you even doing here? I told you to be gone from me forever!
You said for the rest of the day at least, and it's been a whole night, a whole day more than that already.
Fine, you can stay, as long as you're not rude to Wendy.
Don't worry, Peter. She's only saying that because she's an abandoned little creature. It's time I got back to my Wendy house anyway.
Do you want me to walk you home, Wendy?
It's all right. It's not far. Good night, lost boys. May your mind be tidy whilst you sleep and your prettier thoughts ready to put on in the morning.
Good night, Wendy!
Good night, Mother!
Good night, and don't get up to any mischief.
Don't get up to any mischief? What am I supposed to do? Sleep into the grown-ups.
An abandoned little creature? How dare she call me that? And what on earth in Neverland does that mean? Well, I won't be abandoned, whatever that means. She may be a big, ugly girl, but I could pack quite a punch in my own way. If she wants a fight, then she's got to fight.
Right. I think this must be the place.
How do you know?
I know because we have been walking for the long time.
In circles, that's about where we started.
We started on the ship, anchored out at sea. If we were back where we started, then we would have got wet along the way.
I did feel a bit of rain, actually.
But you didn't fall into the sea, did you, you pox-faced parrot? So clearly we are not back at the ship.
You're probably right.
Probably. There is no probably about it. We are not at the ship. We are at the Wendy house. Look, look, there is even a sign to say so.
Aha, just as I thought. Right, let's go in and get her then.
No, stop! You can't just go in there. What if the Lost Boys are there?
Why would the Lost Boys be there? They could be our national team. I hear Wendy does a good scone and jam.
Why would they be having afternoon tea in the middle of the night?
I often get a bit peckish myself in the middle of the night.
Yes, but you wouldn't be having afternoon tea.
Well, not a big one at least.
Oh, shh, shh, shh. I thought I heard something. Quick, quick, we'd better hide.
You talk with Peter Pan. He in danger.
Danger? Not serious danger, I hope.
Yes, Captain Hook's at trap, I hear. He kidnapped you.
Kidnap? But that's the worst kind of nap there is. Far worse than a cat nap. Even a ginger's nap would be better, and I don't like them at all.
But why
would Hook want to kidnap me?
To capture Peter. Peter Hook, Emily.
Oh, well then I must be on the lookout the whole time. I must be.
You must be blind! Ha ha ha! And deaf! Put your hands up in the air, you two! You are coming with us!
Oh my goodness, who are you?
Baby Pratt.
Pratt?
Yes, Pratt. Hook Pratt on the Pratt ship.
Call us what you like, Mr. McDonald's. You have your hands in the air and just life expectancy. Now move it. There's Hook with your name on it.
My name is Wendy Moira and Della Valley, and it would have to be a pretty big hook to have that one.
No, we just have to make the letters a bit smaller.
Oh, don't be such a dunderhead, Starkey. Come on, let's get them marching. Tonight we will be the toast of the galley. Two little fishies for the price of one. Ha ha! Get them!
Don't
want to help.
dogs got up. I'm going to give them to the count of 10, then if they're not back, then I'll hang them by the gibbet. 1.
Nala should be here, Sea Captain.
2.
If you lose many more men, you'll have to get your own people, kids.
3.
I can see them coming, Captain. They're about over there getting even closer.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, what rotten luck.
Isn't that bad form, Captain?
Bad form? Oh, you're probably right. It's me. They may live, for the time being. The clock! It's coming for me! It wants to horse me! What's the other hand? The legs, the manly chest, the beautiful face. It wants to horse me! Save me! Hi, Bruce! Just tell him I'm otherwise engaged today!
It would appear, Captain, that the clock has been fished.
Really? Yeah. What's it up to?
It's up to Seckle's
elbow. Ah! Empty! Oh, thank goodness! What a selfless fellow is that, Seckle! Double rations for you, Seckle! Triple if you don't make it back alive!
say if we all have Tiger Lily? Tiger Lily?
She's not here. Why Tiger Lily?
Tiger Lily never returned. Wait, we wait.
We know where to we look.
Hunt.
Find.
We think Peter Pan taken Lost Boys too.
Me too think they're trouble.
Kill. Wait, we find, we ask, we see.
Lost Boys, you're finally up.
Hooray! I thought you were going to sleep all day. Guess what? I have such exciting news. Go on, I'll give you three guesses.
Did you listen to the podcast without pricking yourself?
No. I might do that tomorrow. Next guess.
Did you tell me I finished chunking or not?
No. Do you think that would be possible?
I think it would be cruel. And an elephant wouldn't be able to breathe, and it wouldn't be able to eat, and it probably won't be able to talk either.
Right. Next guess. Come on, it's something truly amazing.
I've got it. Did you stop the typhoon going out just for one night?
Ooh, I stopped the moon from coming up.
Awesome from going down.
Well, it's not truly amazing as that.
What is it then?
Go on, I'll tell you then. Where's Wendy?
She doesn't seem to be here.
Is that why we haven't eaten breakfast?
I thought she was with you, Peter. I haven't seen her since last night.
Neither have I.
Neither have I.
Not me.
Me neither.
Oh my goodness.
That means she's been gone for ages and ages.
Perhaps 5 or 6 ages.
Oh my goodness.
She could be trapped in an underground cave.
She could be surrounded by a herd of lions.
It's called pride.
She could be inside the chicken crocodile.
Oh my goodness.
Don't be silly, the chicken crocodile only has time for book. In fact, that sounds like Wendy coming along right now.
I don't remember Wendy sounding like that.
Peter Pan, we have word.
Word of what?
Where's Tiger Lily? You take her. She's your prisoner.
Is she?
Not in the slightest, isn't it, slightly?
Not in the slightest.
We do have some pirates currently in prison. No Tiger Lily, no tigers at all, actually.
I've seen Tiger Lily on a number of occasions. If she was indeed one of our prisoners, I would have made it my business to know about it.
Huh?
She's not here.
And Wendy's not here either.
And Wendy's not here either.
Then maybe they're together. Perhaps they've gone hunting for a wild boar.
Don't be silly, Curly. If they're together, they've probably gone shopping or to a matinee.
Tingle, no.
She kept a very close eye on since Wendy arrived. Tinkerbell! Come here, please! Do you know where Wendy and Tiger Lily are?
No.
Are they together?
No.
Are you lying?
No.
Are you telling the truth?
No.
Are they in danger?
No.
Are they safe?
No.
No.
I mean yes.
Are they in danger?
Yes. I mean no.
Tinkerbell, I will feed you to the hungry pigs if you don't start telling the truth. Now tell me, where are Wendy and Tiger Lily?
They were taken by pirates and they were captured by pirates and taken to Captain Hook.
Oh my goodness!
Poor Wendy.
Poor Tiger Lily. If you give yourself up, Peter, he'll kill you. He'll throw you to the shark, piece by piece.
Oh, Peter, don't give yourself up.
You come with us. We give you Hook, he gives us Tiger Lily.
Hang on, that's not fair at all.
We go and get her now.
The only thing you're going to get is an arrow in the heart. Doesn't involve me dying. Tink, go and visit the pirates and find out more information. If you don't find any, then don't bother coming.
Everyone else,
put your weapons down, please.
Do you think we can eat instead? It must almost be time for 11s, and I haven't eaten even had my breakfast yet.
What a good idea. Let's eat. Let's all eat, our guests included. You know you should never make important decisions on an empty stomach.
Scheme and plot too. Bring me the native.
Duke, second, bring the native.
What are you thinking, Captain?
I'm thinking we've got one too many hostages, which makes us too much of a target for too many enemies all at once.
You mean?
Yes, me. It's time for the tiger to lose its stripes. We're going to kill Tiger Lily. Well, I'm not. I can't abide cruelty to animals. Send Duke and Starkey.
Yes, Captain.
Tell them to dump in the lake near to the home of the Lost Boys. Let's point the finger of blame away from this ship.
Aye, aye, Captain. Duke, Starkey, you heard the Captain. Follow them to the letter.
I thought he was to the lake.
Just go, will you?
Leave her alone, you ruffians. What's she ever done to you?
She chopped my hair off with an axe.
She chopped my big toe off with the same, and now I can only walk in straight lines when I'm drunk.
Be that as it may, she does not deserve to be killed. Just you wait until Peter finds out about this. He'll be more vengeful than you've ever seen. Just you wait.
Oh, I'll be waiting, young miss. We will all be waiting.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? How do I mean?
You're exactly what
strange way I always do, then put the lid back on and the turtle to its hiding place.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, didn't happen.
I watched it happen. I saw it with my own blinking eyes.
If you were blinking, then you might have mistaken what you saw.
I didn't mistake anything.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
You really did.
I really didn't.
Yes, you did.
You did, you did, you did.
What then?
What did I mistake?
It was rum, not gin.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Come on, hand it over.
I can't.
Why not?
It's run out. Empty, finito. Here, look.
Well, I can't dump what's the best in the sea without a bit of Dutch courage.
Well, one of these lot is bound to have something to throw away.
More than one for Bluxham. Come on then, who likes tipple? Who snuck something past guard dog Becky at the door?
You, sir, you're looking particularly ready this evening. What have you got for me? Has he been slurring his words much?
Is that really just the water?
It's not, is it?
We both know it's not.
Mother's ruin, remember that.
No, I've got nothing new to clean things bottle already.
Well, I say, Aunt, I know you hold it down a stressful position. I just didn't realise it was as stressful as that. Do you mind if I had myself a suck on? Let me take the bottle. Save that taxi ride home tonight.
I'll take that stack. If I let you have it, it'll be gone by the time we get back to the boat. Oh, that strong stuff that is. You don't do things by halves, do you, Anne?
Right, let's naturalise some native.
I think you mean neutralise, unless that is. You want to turn her into a pirate?
Bill, am I missing something?
Yes, numerous brain cells. Why do you ask?
Am I missing something bigger?
Like a brain?
No, like Tiger Lily. I don't suppose you've got a second bottle, have you?
Okay.
He's not coming missing.
He's not coming missing.
Perhaps he'll have an hard time.
Was that a joke? It was dreadful.
You thought that was dreadful? Clearly you haven't heard one about the pipe who had a nervous breakdown.
He needs an
Here is one, here is one. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting pirate.
Help, save me, Peter, before they tell another one.
What did the pirate say when he sat on the porcupine? You're a pain in the
ass. Stop, stop it, please. I can't take any more. Death by punch. What a way to go.
Going to be even more painful.
If that's possible.
And seeing as we have clearly been abandoned, we might as well get started. I think we'll take a big toad to begin with. Who wants one of her toes?
I'll take one, Captain.
No, 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 Sicko, you wait for one of her arms. Ah. Mullins, you're short of a toe, aren't you? No, not yet. Not ready. I haven't even shaved. Please, just not today.
Maybe it's here for the rest of Sekko.
Oh, I do hope so. Quickly, Sekko, off for yourself. The life is worth far less than mine. Pants!
Oh, look. If you could only see your face.
Why, you lavender-faced limpet. You've got a nerve. Get in!
Wait! Don't you want to question me before you kill me?
No, we want to kill you, then question you. You got a problem with that?
No, but you might.
Let's hear it then, boy. Why are you here?
I'm here. I'm here to take to offer a place of Wendy.
No, Peter!
Yes, Wendy, and some of the Lost Boys. What kind of gentleman would we be if we lived here so some painful death?
You'd be pirates.
Precisely.
Prove it. Put down your weapons.
We are an arm.
Ha, you and me both.
Are you seriously telling me that you've boarded my ship full of the most pernicious pirates imaginable. Without a sword? Oh, Peter, Peter, Peter. What a childish mistake. What possible reason would I have to free her now? No, she's as dead as you are, and you're a fossil infamy.
I knew you would say something like that, Hope, because you've always been predictable.
Oh, really? We'll see about that.
Hope!
You didn't predict that, did you?
Get out of here, Hope, or I'll really make you pay for this.
Will you now? You and... Who's on it?
Well... comes to mention it.
But you're dead.
Me not dead. Me angry.
Me very angry.
Ah, yes. Well, the thing is, I'd love to stay and talk this through, man to ogre. But actually, I've got dinner plans.
I think someone else has got dinner plans as well. Time to have plans.
No, go away. Withdraw. Shoo. We need him. You don't want to win this way, surely. Where's your fighting spirit? We must do all. It's the only way.
Don't do it, Peter.
Unless, of course, you're too frightened. I forget sometimes that you're only a little boy, a small, motherless child.
I'm not frightened of you. I'm not frightened, at least, of all you.
The most wonderful stories.
them beautifully. It was my favourite time of the day.
Mothers are wonderful things, so much I do know.
You're right, Tootles, and ours was especially wonderful. But it's time for us to go home.
But what if they have forgotten about us? What if the window is shut?
John, don't you know anything about a mother's love? A mother can never forget her children.
But what about if the window is closed too, Wendy?
It won't be Michael, trust me.
But what about if there's someone else sleeping in my bed?
There will be, I promise.
But what about Neverland, though? I'm going to miss it ever so much.
So will I. I'm not sure I want to go.
Don't worry, we'll come back and visit. I really mean it.
Little part of us will always stay forever. Goodbye.
crying there, because I was crying, and they're not my kids, but wow. Such a proud drama teacher on stage right at the moment. Guys, I'm absolutely proud of each and every one of you. Young lady, very proud of you at the moment. Well done to the entire cast. Massive round of applause, please.